an unlawful look at an extraordinary theory of everything.
Part A.
Introduction to the Logos Heuristic. I am Antonio Casella, the reader who reaches Amazon's Kindle store
or Amazon Prime and then searches for Antonio Casella will arrive at my 18 digital and 16 printed books
about my proposition that a humanistic understanding of the alliance of the primary attention with the secondary attention may transform into progress the dangers of global warming and fundamentalist-driven terrorism. In the short interview, An Unlawful Look at an Extraordinary Theory of Everything, the down-to-earth principles of local space-time, in the first attention less harmed in the autistic spectrum, and the strange principles of non-local hyperspace in the second attention harmed in autism are combined into the third attention. The third attention channels both the need of the first attention and the malice of the second attention, sustaining the progress of those who learn to read in writing and those who learn to write in reading. Shakespeare, for example, joined grammar in local space-time 1 to pragmatics in non-local hyperspace 2 when he wrote Hamlet in 3. The interview here about the Logos Heuristic is divided into four parts. An introduction to a theory of everything, seen as the dance of locality and non-locality. The relationship between autism and the demigod explorer Quetzalcoatl. The social meaning of Mona Lisa and the Vitruvian Man by Leonardo da Vinci, and the play of the principle of creation in La Natività, Nativity Scene, in a known painting by Leonardo. The 15 questions and answers of An Unlawful Look at an Extraordinary Theory of Everything are published through Amazon Kindle in English, Spanish, and Italian. They make a 10,000 words introduction to a larger writing, the 200,000 words and 300 questions and answers of the three labyrinths of Thus Returned Quetzalcoatl. In the series Thus Returned Quetzalcoatl, which is also published in English, Spanish, and Italian, the labyrinth in The Way of Hunting revolves around the first attention, the respect adored by our artistic facet, and the need for conserving the known world. The labyrinth of The Way of War is centered on the second attention, the talent displayed by our artistic facet, and the renovation needed to overcome terrorism and global warming. Finally, The Way to Progress seeks the third attention by emphasizing the balance of autistic respect with artistic talent, not the first with the second attention. The three ways of Thus Returned Quetzalcoatl correspond to three nocturnal interviews in 2013, from October 31st to November the 2nd. The three long interviews took place in Spanish at a refuge located on La Cuchilla del Niño, the Crest of the Child, the misty mountains of the Venezuelan Andes. In the lower right corner of the image exposed, the reader may appreciate a picture of El Niño de la Cuchilla, or the Child of the Mountain. The little statue, which is hosted at the top of La Cuchilla del Niño, delineates a sleeping baby whose head rests on a skull while his navel joins a sphere. The image of that child may be taken as a metaphor for any new natural system, a word, a work, or a world within a progress born of dreams located within life and death, sanity and madness, or autism and schizophrenia. The aim of the interviews that took place on the Cuchilla del Niño, of my research and of my books, is showing that the progress of all natural systems and the reading of all sacred texts, for example, the Book of Mormon, Bhagavad Gita, Bor Vuh, and Tao Te Ching, is fed by the humanistic use of quantum computing in the second attention. A humanistic understanding of the strange principles of the second attention will help a sober hunter, a daring warrior, and a kind sage to cross unknown labyrinths, from the arrogant knowledge located in the first attention, through prudent ignorance in the second attention, into the wisdom hidden at the center of the third attention. As Hitler did by sequestering the true meaning of the Sanskrit swastika, however, the devil will always try to cling to power by using the power of lying hidden in the second attention. Truth is elusive indeed.
On June 21st, 2015, the online magazine Zest Today published the original account of the introduction to the 300 questions and answers of the three labyrinths of Thus Returned Quetzalcoatl. The 15 questions and answers I offer here are a bit more comprehensive than the interview handled by Donatella Marcovigi, Zest correspondent in the USA. Indeed, my review lies halfway between spontaneity and the suggestions born at the crossing of reality and fantasy.
Similarly, after the condemnation to exile of Titus Annius Milo in 52 before the Common Era, the Roman lawyer Cicero rewrote his best pro Milone defense and sent it to the exiled politician. Milo answered, "O Cicero, si sic dixisse, non ego barbato species, massiliae ederim. O Cicero, if you had talked like this, I would not be eating red mullets in Marseille." I hope that the inclusion of additional figures, a stronger emphasis on the alliance of the autistic and the artistic facets of the human mind, and the chain of subtle interventions may improve the understanding of an extraordinary theory of everything and induce our return from exile. Let us begin with the first question.
Dr. Casella, what cognitive secrets do you unveil in the three labyrinths of the series Thus Returned Quetzalcoatl?
The three labyrinths of Thus Returned Quetzalcoatl reflect three main aspects of the Logos psychological heuristic.
Shared knowledge on the way of hunting of the first attention shows minor damage in the spectrum of autism and major damage in the spectrum of schizophrenia. The renovation of knowledge on the way of war attached to the non-locality of quantum computing in the second attention abandons autistics before they reach the age of 3 years and schizophrenics around the age of 20 or 30 years. Finally, the reciprocal empowerment of the first and the second attention on the way to progress leads to the humor and forgiveness that embody the third attention. The following examples, organized under the Spanish alphabet, may lead the little prince hidden in any normal person to the dance of autistic sequence with artistic simultaneity, or the classical locality guarded by the first attention with the quantum non-locality explored by the second attention. Let us begin with the letter A. The autistic memory of what we know with the artistic memory of what we never knew before. B. The semantics that conserves prototypical meanings with the pragmatics that adorns them with new metaphors. C. The literal interpretation of any sacred text with the invisible teachings behind its visible letters. D. The invariable letter A of the Latin alphabet with the variable B, which becomes D, P, and Q when we rotate it. E. The relativity of simultaneity with the simultaneity of relativity. F. The loneliness of the host before consecration with Martin Luther's proposition that before its transubstantiation into Christ, the host shares the same space at the same time with the body of the Redeemer.
G. Hating the enemy that crucifies us with regretting our trespasses and blessing our tormentors.
H. The local trips of Muhammad as a merchant with his non-local trip as a prophet from Mecca to the farthest mosque and back to Mecca in the same night. I. The rigidity of the desert of Hejaz with the flexibility of the cumber of straw on which the prophet kneeled. J. The classical ability of Jesus to guide into his wound the hand of the apostle Thomas with Christ's quantum capacity for entering the house of the apostles through a locked door. K, the stone pillow that supported Jacob's head in Bethel, with his dreaming of a ramp laid between the earth and the sky. L, the diurnal fight of Jacob and Laban in Aram, with the nocturnal struggle of Israel with an angel in Penuel. M, the enmity that separates two armies in the Bhagavad Gita, with the anguish of Arjuna Gandivadavan, the warrior who does not want to harm the friends enlisted in both factions. N, the irreversibility of the second law of thermodynamics, felt by the lords of the Shibalba when they cut the gush Palanke Unapu in Popolvuh, with its reversibility when the secretly reborn twins lead their assassins to a truly irreversible death. Enyu, the selfish dreams of the Egyptian nobles around the 17th century before the Common Era, with the unselfish dream of Pharaoh
about seven lean cows eating seven fat cows, and with the humanistic dream of Joseph about conserving the wheat produced in the years of abundance. Oh, the classical strategy of the Roman Varro with the quantum strategy of the Carthaginian Hannibal at the Battle of Cannae in 216 before the Common Era. P, the love of bricks by Gilgamesh in the 3rd millennium before the Common Era, with the love of forests by his friend Enkidu. Q, Adam's artistic obedience with Eve's artistic disobedience.
R, the Arhat who seeks his own enlightenment with the Bodhisattva who seeks the enlightenment of his enemies. S, seeing a lotus flower with exploring why it is born from mud. T, the perfect repetition of rites sought by Confucius with the less than perfect creativity sought by Lao Tzu.
U, the clarity of the masculine yang with the darkness of the feminine yin. V, focused attention in the Dalai Lama meditating Dharamsala with mindfulness in the Dalai Lama who meditates simultaneously in Dharamsala and in Beijing. W, the irreversible sequence followed by the arrow with the reversible simultaneity of the bow. X, the slops of the sun with the caresses of the moon. Y, the pyramid of the sun with the pyramid of the moon at Teotihuacan. Z, the brightness of the day with the fuzzy going of Quetzalcoatl to Venus before dawn and the dark return of Quetzalcoatl to Earth after sunset.
In a quantum voyage that enriches two readers.
Which readers will your three books on nature's nature enrich?
The 300 questions and answers of the three labyrinths of dust returning Quetzalcoatl will enrich the very rich that until now have remained insensitive to the consequences of their excessive exploitation of the commons of the earth, for example, oceans, glaciers, aquifers, and forests, and the very poor who sing burn, baby, burn, while they destroy the material riches they see but do not own. Few people in the world value the capacity of creation hidden in the human brain.
Rest sure, however, that the poorest person in the world will not change his cognitive riches for the cognitive poverty of an autistic billionaire. Today, the very rich, the very poor, fundamentalists, suckers, and the malicious leaders who always promise them what they could never give are blind to the return of Quetzalcoatl from Venus. That said, any person may wake up to four considerations. Autistics cannot go with Quetzalcoatl toward Venus. The Quetzalcoatl who embraces the morning star, the moon, and quantum coherence is a devil. Schizophrenics cannot return from Venus to the Earth by means of quantum decoherence and evening star, and hope in embrace of the moon with evening star in solemn seal, the saving syllable Om, Laozi's way. And in any cross may help our inner Quetzalcoatl gather the help of our quantum devil.
The dismal reality of autistics and schizophrenics supports the belief by ancient Mesoamericans that the grace of the second attention will convince Quetzalcoatl into returning to the earth with the evening star and the secret of nature's nature.
The universal pervasiveness of the third attention.